Thank you. Thank you. You can imagine how I'm feeling tonight. First time in Greece, the place I was born, and especially at the Herodian Theater, right under the Parthenon. It's one of my life's biggest dreams, and it's becoming a reality tonight. Όπως καταλαβαίνετε, το περίμενε αυτό. And the next song I would like to do for you is for my new album, and it's about not forgetting how to enjoy life. You know, sometimes we get caught up in our troubles and our problems, and we let life sort of slip away, and life is precious, all of life, and one must try to take in as much of it as possible. The song is called Until the Last Moment. Μέχρι τελευταία στιγμή.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, stop over here. The next song I wrote for the woman that brought me in this world. She has a very sweet voice, and she used to sing to me when I was a kid. In fact, she tells me now that I wouldn't go to sleep at nights unless she sang for me. In fact, she calls me Nyktopulli. This song captures her gentleness and her sweetness. It's called Felitsa, and Felitsa is my mother, and she's here tonight. And I'd like to dedicate this one to her. Thank you, Sena Felitsa.
Thank you.
Το επόμενο κομμάτι, να μιλήσουμε και λίγο ελληνικά. Το επόμενο κομμάτι περιγράφει ένα συνέστημα το οποίο έχω αισθανθεί πολλές φορές στη ζωή μου, επειδή έχω λείψει για πολλά χρόνια από το μέρος που γεννήθηκα, την Ελλάδα και ιδιαίτερα την Καλαμάτα. Το κομμάτι λέγεται Νοσταλγία και θα ήθελα να σας το αφιερώσω. Εσάς. You may have noticed there's a few more musicians on stage. I really appreciate the fact that they came here tonight and they're helping us to bring this music to life. It's one thing to hear music in my mind, it's another thing to have it materialized so that you can hear it. They came all the way from London, and I think they're some of the best musicians in the world. They're the Royal Philharmonic Concert Orchestra.
Thank you.
I would like to leave you with a couple of thoughts. A little while back, I was watching an interview with one of the astronauts from the space shuttle. And in this interview, he was describing his experiences while he was orbiting the planet. And he was saying how beautiful Earth looks from above. But he said that much to his surprise, when he was going over Europe, he found that he was having a hard time telling the countries apart from each other. He said the reason for that was that the lines that are in the maps are not in the ground. It makes a great point. These lines really don't exist. They're made up completely, and they perpetuate this illusion that somehow we're all different from each other. And I think the world would be a much better place if someday we stopped pretending that these lines exist and we concentrated on our similarities rather than our differences. And I just want you to remember one more thing, that everything great that has ever happened to humanity since the beginning has begun as a single thought in someone's mind. And if any one of us is capable of such a great thought, then all of us have the same capacity, capability, because we're all the same. Thank you all for coming.
right? No, no, no. They liked it. They liked it.
Stand up.
Bravo.